Hello and welcome to this new episode of the podcast of Audio Game Association. I'm Marta. Today I'm here with Manuele Bonini. Hi Manuele, it's a pleasure to have you here. How are you?
Hey there, I'm fine, thanks. You? Always fine?
Yeah, I'm fine, thank you. Well, in this episode we're talking about The Frost Demon, the new standalone adventure by Audio Game Association. But first of all, Manuele, what was your role in the making of The Frost Demon?
At the beginning, I worked on another video game. And when the release date of The Frost Demon was approaching, I helped Alessandro Corazza with some testing and bug fixing, some audio design. So really marginal work. But with the next update, I start to work full-time on the new demo. So I try to write, come across with a new design and programming. And well, it was fun to program, but it's also very frustrating. And I asked my colleagues for very, very much help. Mm-hmm. And very often, and I would absolutely not have solved anything without them. And they, like this morning too, they gave me so many advices to make the game better. So, yeah.
Yeah, I think that this is one of the best things of teamwork, that mutual help, isn't it? So, I agree. Well. Yeah. What brings you here in the world of audio games?
I don't always I always loved the video games, but I never thought I'd work in the industry. It was like a strange coincidence. Mm-hmm. I studied communication, and I always loved writing and reading, and really, really loved storytelling. So I would have liked to do this for work of writing and tell people stories. Mm-hmm. So I followed a course by Ivan Venturi, my current boss. I did an internship for an audio game association, and from then on we started collaborating. These kinds of games are focused on the things that I really, really love and on I really, really interested. Mm-hmm. Storytelling and sound design, of course. But I do some work in a radio, university radio, so I really, really love work with sound and music. And then I had to learn handle new thing, like I said before, programming, that was quite difficult to me. It's like to learn a new language. Yes. And yeah, I think back 1 year ago, I had from 1 year ago, I learned so much new things. Mm-hmm. And even if I wanted to cry sometime while programming, because it can be very, very frustrating to me.
Yes, sometimes new things, I think, they can be a little overwhelming. But let me tell you, you've done a wonderful job, in my opinion.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Speaking of The Frost Demon, you have made a few changes. There are some new things that are worth underlying. What have you changed in the fighting system compared to the other chapters of the Blind Quest saga, if we can call it that way?
Yeah, so this morning I did a list of all the changes. I'm really, really happy because I didn't notice there were so many changes. I'm really proud of them. Mm-hmm. So the combat system is the biggest change, because it has always been a problem for Blindcast. Mm-hmm. From the beginning, Max De Pasquale, the first programmer and my actual tutor, made a lot of improvements in the combat system, and I believe that I am also moving in the right direction to make the game better. The combat system now is more really, really, really more complex from the first state of the game. But Nathan and his enemies have a fast and heavy attack. There are less indication from the narrator, so the players will have to be more careful. The fight, the battle are really, really hectic. I hope we remove the really discuss mechanic of spamming key. So now the player is it will be he will be punished if continue to spamming key, and I hope the player appreciates that. And their keyboards too, because the Bencast one was called for some time the game who bring you to change your keyboard because you it will surely broke.
Okay.
Our community indeed has given us a lot of feedback, like the feedback about spamming key. And even if I have not been able to follow them all, slowly but surely we will get it there.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, while our community will play in the demo, I will continue to improve the game by following their advices and my ideas. During the fight, for example, now it's possible to know exactly the number of damage inflicted and suffered, something that the players has wanted for a while, and that finally I can I had implemented, but I would also like to create one more layer of complexity, like a combo, make Nathan have ability, but we will see.
Well, okay.
That's all.
Yeah, thank you. I think a fantasy story like The Frost Demon is interesting because, among other aspects, the play can be whoever or whatever he wants. You know, you can live in a different world, right? Can you tell us about this side of the game, like quests or equipment system, for example?
Yeah, I love RPGs for the exactly same reason. And the other world in this particular history time, I think, are a better place to go. Mm-hmm. We want to give an identity to our protagonist and not like other RPG, give the player the freedom to be themselves, because we think one fixed protagonist have a better chance to create a better story. Mm-hmm. But the player has still has room to write his deeds. Mm-hmm. Given that, the story is the threat of a blind cast, and I want to try to explain expand it a bit, especially since the player want more side quest. And by introducing the new equipment system, which worked through crafting and NPC, so with a new quest, I was able to insert a small series of side mission along with the in-depth gameplay. So in Italian we say tu piccioni con una fava. In English I don't know what the sentence is. The
like
system is quite
sorry. Like you have two birds only with one piece of food, like.
Yes, I think it's two birds with one bullet.
You're right. Sorry.
The system. No problem. The system is still quite basic, but there's space to improvement, and I think it will please anyway the player when they notice the damage increase as the adventure progresses.
Okay, well, last question. What about music and dubbing?
Unfortunately, I didn't work directly on the music and most of the script, but I hope I can give them a little more attention in the future. But one point we are trying to understand is how and when implement a synthetic voice system or reader compatibility like NVDA. The ability to customize the speed of text, insert automatic translation and similar functionality is a high demand from the community. It will be a really, really strength for the game. The big problem that we have is that I will have to totally rewrite the program behind Bindcast, and it's a huge job, especially for me, to do it on an already complete title. It will certainly beyond the first task we think about for the sequel, but for now I have to wait. Anyway, I also believe that a human narrator like David McCallion gives more interesting nuance to the story. although Ben Cast voice acting is a little over the top, maybe, but I think in the future we can think about both narrator and screen reader compatibility. We'll see.
Well, I'm curious to see what you'll come up with. We have seen a little part of The Frost Demon, the new standalone adventure of Blindcast. And I'd like to remind you all that you can find the audio game on audiogame.store, and there's the link in the description. Thank you so much, Manuele. Congratulations on your work, and good luck for your future and for everything. Thank you for listening to this episode of the podcast of Audio Game Association, and goodbye till next time. Bye.
Bye-bye.